Back in the olden days, the Philippine National Railways was said to be an incredible engineering masterpiece in the country, and people expected that it would continue to be a star project amongst other infrastructures. However, after being more than 100 years old, significant progress hasn't really been seen for decades. But as of recent times, things are starting to change. But before we go there, we first need to go back to June 26, 1875, the time when King Alfonso XIII of Spain emitted a royal decree which established that the Inspector of Public Works of the Philippine Islands, Don Eduardo Lopez Navarro, was required to submit a general plan for the establishment of a railroad line in the island of Luzon. It took him 5 whole months of studying, planning, and plotting until he came up with the Memoria sobre el Plan General de Ferrocarriles en la Isla de Luzon. It was the strategy that had created the country's first ever railway system. Eventually, the concession for the construction of the railroad was awarded to Don Edmundo Sykes and later became known as the Manila Railroad Company. In the following stages, engineers and inspectors would lay down the groundwork for establishing the railway. It was approximately around 200 kilometers worth of track lines, and eventually, decades go by, further expansion was swift, finally reaching the southern region of Luzon, where more than 1,000 kilometers of line was constructed. However, as ages pass by, the expansions has been moving relatively slow. There was even a time when over 20 years went by, and things had been at a sluggish pace. Only until recently, though, when several lawmakers across the country filed a number of bills for the modernization and reconstruction of the PNR. These operations are known to be as the railway system, running from New Clark City all the way over to Metro Manila, the North-South Commuter Line, the rehabilitation of the South Commuter Lines, and the soon-to-be long-haul service line. This whole framework of this modernization plan is expected to be around 4,000 kilometers of rail track. Quite an ambitious project indeed. On top of all these, a newly proposed project that would be way over to the southern islands of the Philippines, called the Mindanao Railway, was introduced. It was a system that would span over 2,000 kilometers, and it would go around the whole region and connect the major cities. This will involve the creation of the MRC, also known as the Mindanao Railways Corporation, where it would be the one responsible to establish, operate, develop, and maintain the railway transportation in the area. The first phase for this is expected to start in the year 2021 and cost over 36 billion pesos. This is a big thing for the growth of the national railway industry in the Philippines, which seeks to create a proper national railway system. The NRI encompasses the islands of Visayas, Mindanao, Luzon, and the metropolitan areas in the Philippines. They also seek to consolidate all existing rail offices and agencies. And besides this, other railway systems have been proposed, such as those by Bill HB 2027. It was filed proposing to establish a railway system that will be used to connect both La Union and Ilocos Norte. On the other hand, another bill known as the HB 1911 sought to create a Central Luzon Railways Corporation, which would serve, as expected, as the railroad and transportation policy for Central Luzon. The state of the Philippine railway system is far from what it could be. There's a consistent effort from the government to improve the system, and after all, the railway operation is a big part of the country's transit system. Knowing that this is vital to the economy, it's essential that the railway system is improved in the coming years. Without a doubt, the golden age of the PNR, after all was said and done, was the period of 1954 to 1960. With the Manila Railroad Company succeeding massively, even receiving the Business Firm of the Year award from the Business Writers Association of the Philippines, things were going great for it. Congress passed laws to fund the extension lines and improve them, with plans to extend the southern line to also include Sorsogon and also the lines from Nueva Ecija to the Cagayan. Congress also set money apart to provide improvement and support to the lines from Bulacan, Cabanatuan City, and Plaridel. Regarding its current state, the Philippine National Railways is experiencing a massive rework and modernization project after receiving enough funding and assistance from the JICA, the Japan International Cooperation Agency, to cover the development of existing branch lines, roughly 653 kilometers in total, and also a 38-kilometer commuter train that leads from Tutuban to Malolos. Doesn't that sound amazing? Among the main benefits of rail transport over road transportation, we can mention the proven efficiency and also reliability of rail freight, and its quick options that provide access to capacity, on top of a more environmentally friendly shipping process via train. Anyway, what are your thoughts on the intriguing history of the Philippine National Railways and its future of expansion? Let us know in the comments. Also, make sure to leave us a like. Follow us for more amazing videos. Thanks for watching.